Around 7 a.m., we suddenly heard a massive bomb. Dust covered the place. I opened my front door and went out. There were around 50 people laying on the ground. That was outside my house. I was able to treat a couple of them before the second strike hit. Then I felt dizzy. I thought it was normal because of the dust, so I continued to attend to the people. Then the airstrikes hit a third time. I was 20 meters away from where it hit. After the fourth strike, I felt my body give up on me. I felt so dizzy that I collapsed to the ground. I stood up, tried to walk a bit, but I fell again. I felt my body not responding. I felt a toxic material taking over.
Without prior notice, the barrel dropped on us. The stench of the chemicals covered the place. We fell unconscious, all of us all together. I woke up and found myself here, in this medical place. I don't know where my children are, in which medical place they are, I don't know. We were sleeping at home. We are not criminals. We were fast asleep. Children, elderly, we're all fast asleep in my house. It was early morning. We are not criminals. May God never bless them.
اليوم صباحا بتاريخ 4/4
On April 4, 2017, we received scores of injured people from Khan Sheikhoun town. These injuries showed symptoms of being hit by toxic gas. Until now, no medical staff was able to determine its kind. Those who were affected by this toxic gas showed symptoms of non-reactive pinpoint pupils, constant shivering with the yellowish foam coming out of the mouth and a state of unconsciousness. We treated them as soon as possible, despite the lack of medical staff and equipment, which all of the medical points in the liberated areas suffer from. The very critical cases were transported to the medical points located along the Syrian-Turkish borders, some of which were transported across the borders to Turkish hospitals.